Hey guys, this is Alachia, and I have a spider on my head. This is going to be a film tag. So I was tagged by Marian and Neil to do the Stranger Things film tag. All right, so let's get into this. So, number one, epic intro. The opening sequence of Stranger Things is amazing and really grabs your attention. Name a film that grabbed your attention from the first scene. So for me, that is undoubtedly Pride and Prejudice. This is an opening sequence that is done in one continuous shot, and I absolutely find it just eye candy. It is so much eye candy for me. I don't really even understand how it was shot in one continuous, like, how it is made in one continuous shot, but I was just absolutely floored and just thrilled with that. The cinematic experience of that was something for me to sit there and watch over and over again. That's what I will do. I'll actually watch that opening sequence over and over again. Number two, Dungeons and Dragons. Name a fantasy world you would like to experience yourself. Okay, so I originally picked Final Fantasy XI. However, I realized it had to be in film, so I changed it to The Golden Compass, mainly because I really love the idea of daemons. Daemons are kind of like your soul, or an idea of the soul, but it's encapsulated in an animal that you like kind of have as a companion. And I just was thinking like, oh man, I would love to have Daisy as my soul companion and be able to talk with her and just do stuff with her. That to me would be amazing. Number three, squad goals. When 11 met Mike, Dustin, and Lucas, it was a mostly perfect team. Name your favorite group of friends. Spice Girls from the Spice World? If you wanna be my lover, gotta get with my friends. No? No? Okay, fine. Fine! The kids from Goonies then. I was really jealous of them when I was a kid, and I was like, oh man, those kids are like, they are tight friends, and I never had that kind of relationships with other younger friends back when I was an awkward child. But yes, definitely Goonies. Number four, ABCs and Christmas lights. Joyce Byers goes mad with grief after Will goes missing. Name your favorite mentally unhinged character. Okay, mentally unhinged character. I just got through filming a review about this character. His name is Warwick Wilson. He is a masterful, for me, embodiment of mentally unhinged. It's like sick, twisted, and yet just capable enough to draw back so that you can fit in and blend and you know, and sort of like ease into it. So, because you don't want to be totally psychotic, right? Because then they just lock you up or you get caught. Nah, you want to be just that level of mentally unhinged, but also like have the ability to like work on the surface with everyone else. My second pick would have been Frank Costello from The Departed. Number five, The Upside Down. Name a film that was the opposite of what you expected. Well, that's pretty easy. I just reviewed this film, The Handmaiden. I was expecting it to be a crazy, horrific, terrifying film that was a psychological thriller slash, you know, seeped in darkness, and it just ended up being this like film erotica. So yeah, that's, you can check out that review down below. I'll put the description, but it's definitely not what I was expecting. Number six, mad scientist. Dr. Brenner likes to get freaky with humanity. Name the freakiest dystopian government you can think of. Okay, so that's pretty easy. 1984, definitely. It's not the fact that it's just about a government that's trying to sort of like monitor you, it's Big Brother, you know, on crack. It's the fact that they're not satisfied with the fact that they can control you physically, you know, and constrain you physically. They have to break you mentally as well. Room 101, when I read that, and it's also a film with John Hurt, is just the most terrifying concept I can think of. The idea that this government has to mentally break you. It is not enough that they control every aspect of your life. They need to control your thoughts. They refuse to allow you to have any other feeling than the one that they want you to. And that is just messed up. Number 7, Demogorgon. Name a scary film creature that you would not want to come through your walls. Y'all are gonna laugh at this one. Jaws. Jaws is the most terrifying creature I can think of, period. It is the scariest film I've ever experienced. It psychologically terrified me and scarred me for life. I cannot go into the ocean, open body water of ocean, without literally having a panic attack. And I know that there's so many, like, you know, scientific evidence that I've, you know, read, and I know that sharks, the likelihood of a shark coming up and attacking you is very, 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 very unlikely. Nope. Jaws really messed me up, and sharks are the thing I am the most afraid of in life. Number 8, cliffhanger ending. Name a film that left you wanting more. All right, for me, that is definitely the science fiction movie Stargate. I remember sitting at the end of that film going like, oh my God, my mind is blown. I love this. The idea of the Stargate has so much potential, right? You know, like all the different worlds it could go to in the galaxy, the planets, the sci-fi element, the history of the aliens that have this technology, how they manipulate other worlds, how they interact. Oh, it's just like, oh, I definitely want more. I mean, granted, they ended up giving more with the Star SG-1, Atlantis, SGU. However, I did find, except for SGU, I found the TV shows a little too campy for me and I couldn't get into them, but I did see a couple of the episodes and I really do like some of the sci-fi elements they pulled in there. They are actually going to be rebooting this movie, so it will be interesting to see what they decide to do with that, and I hope it actually pans out because I definitely want to see this more cinematically. All right, thanks so much, Marianne and Neil, for tagging me. And if you haven't checked out her channel, definitely check it out. She does books and film reviews, and she is definitely intellectual. She's thoughtful. I really enjoy watching her reviews. And I'm going to tag Daniel Brown, Mr. Creepypasta, and Chris Stuckman. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching, and if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my The Handmaiden review, or you can click right here and watch my The Perfect Host review. Until next time, see you on the flip side.